everyone, it's Michelle here from 3Ps, and today I'd like to share with you a project idea I had using some cotton embroidery thread or cotton floss. Now the ones I've picked up here, I got all of these at Tuesday morning. I want to say there was about, if I remember, it was like 100 or maybe 120 of these different colored wraps in the bag, and it was under $5. I apologize. I can't remember the exact price. I want to say it was like $3.99 or maybe $4.99. I just know it was under $5. And it came with lots of different colors. I've got some here, the blues, some green, purples, some yellow, pink. So it came with quite a variety pack of different colors. And today I wanted to share with you some little flower embellishments that you can make. Now, I've attached these to some plain, like, I guess these are like wooden craft sticks. I got these, they're just plain. I don't know if you can see, it's just a plain little wooden stick under there. And I just wrapped it in some fabric tape. I got this fabric tape at Dollar Tree. You can also use like the green floral tape. I didn't have any of that, but you can certainly wrap that to make it a green stem, maybe add some leaves to it. I got this color and then this blue one. I got mine at Dollar Tree. It sticks pretty well. And here's another little purple one. And you could probably stick these to maybe pencils. You want to decorate up a pencil or pen, wrap that up. Or, you know, you can make this into, you could add like a pin to the back and make it like a lapel or, you know, any possibilities really. But before I get started on how I actually made these, a couple of tips I'd like to share. This green one here, I'm getting ahead of myself. Let me back up just a little bit. Recently I made some of these for my mom. She had some hip surgery, and I wanted to take her a vase of flowers, but I didn't want, you know, real flowers because I didn't want them to die, you know, while she was at the rehab place. So I thought I could make her like a creative vase of these flowers. And so I put, I think it was like 5 in a vase, and I took them to her. And by the next day, the ones that were, you know, in the vase, they had actually started to hang down, you know, and sag and droop down, and the fibers weren't staying up. So I needed to figure out a way to make it to where when you stick them on something that they stay straight up and they don't sag over. So I came home and decided, you know, I could probably stiffen these with some, you know, craft glue, which is what I did. I'm kind of ashamed to show you this. this is one that, as you can see, is a hot mess. This was the first one that I tried, and a couple of problems with this ugly atrocity here is, one, I ripped the button back off the front, so that's what the yellow thing is in the middle. But I'd use a craft glue, and as you can see, I didn't separate the fibers very well, and it makes it very, very crunchy and stiff. The other thing I did to this one was I used a spray mist, a Tattered Angel spray mist around the front just to see what it would look like. And I think it made it worse. So maybe not spray it or put so much glue on it, but I wanted to show you what happened. And after that, I decided to try something else. Now, this green one here, I also used a craft glue on, and it did stiffen it. I did not spray the front, and I used a little bit less glue on it, so it's not nearly, you know, the fibers aren't, you know, molded together. And it is softer on the front, but it does give like almost a crunchy feel. It has that feel like when you spray your hair, like with hairspray from the 80s, and it has that I'm not gonna move crunchy hairspray feel is what it feels like. So maybe y'all can relate to that. And I just kind of gave away my age a little bit. anyway, moving on. So that's with craft glue. And I really just didn't care for the feel of that. So we're gonna The green one's fine, but we're going to move this ugly thing out of the way so y'all don't have to look at it. Now, these two that I did here, I did with this Mod Podge. Now, I got this little bottle at Target in their little dollar spot, and I believe Dollar Tree has it as well, but I just happened to be at Target, so I picked it up. With the Mod Podge, a couple things. This pink one here, I have the Mod Podge on the front and the back, so if you do too much of it, it still isn't as stiff as the glue was. The reason I had it on the front and the back is because originally I had done the back, and I'd used a hair dryer to help it dry faster, which you can do if you don't want them to air dry, although I think they dry pretty quick even just sitting around. But after I had done that, I thought about putting glitter on the front, so I ended up putting a little Mod Podge on the front so that I could add some glitter. In hindsight, what I should have done is what I did on this purple one. I just put the Mod Podge on the front side and I added some glitter. The back doesn't have any at all. So it still makes it soft where it's not. And the Mod Podge really isn't sticky, or I should say it's not hairspray stiff. And it's not crunchy at all, unlike the craft glue. So those were a couple little things I wanted to share as far as some tips. I would highly recommend using the Mod Podge for this project. And if you are not going to glitter it, obviously you can put either it just on the front or just on the back. Only do one side. But if you are going to, you know, obviously glitter these, I would just put a little bit on the front and then sprinkle it with some glitter. So those are a couple little tips I have on that. So moving on to the actual flower itself, I think I'll do a yellow one. I'll repair the one that I killed. Oh, it's funny the things that we mess up, and it's just like, ew, ick. So anyway, you just take the little wrappers off and you have it like this. And then what you want to do is you're just going to fold it in half like this. So you have it in half. Now what you can do, two ways that you can actually tie this center up to get the center, is you can either just take a string like this and wrap it around, or which you would just, you know, you would do like this in half and you would just wrap it around like this as tight as you can. And then you would just, you know, tie a knot like that. Or you can take a piece of the string and cut a piece off and then just tie it, you know, a regular, you know, tie a knot in the center. Either way works. I just do the center wrap like this. It's pretty easy. And then I just, you know, tie it in a knot in the center. Sorry, my hand's in the way. Okay, I'm pulling that like this. So then you've got a little knot in the center here. And then all you're going to do is you're going to snip away these loops. And if you can pull it apart and get your scissors in all at once, you just cut it in one pass, like that. And then on this other side, you'll do the same thing. One. And two. All right. So now, and then the little string that you use to tie up with, you know, it'll just blend in with either side. Cut the excess off. All right, and then you're just gonna wanna start fanning these out your little fibers. Now, one little tip that you can do is, let me find it here. I don't have a plastic one, so I had to get one from the kitchen drawer, but you could just use a fork. And a fork will pull these fibers apart for you. You can actually just kind of run it through fibers like this, separating out the little pieces. And sometimes you can kind of smush it down with your hand to kind of flatten it out a little bit. Go. Missed a few loops here. I think that's all of them. Yeah. So I thought I had a plastic fork, but I didn't, so might not want to eat dinner with that one. All right, so then you've got a little flat, little flower here. And then what you want to do is grab you a couple buttons. This here. And if you've got like sticky dots or, you know, the ones that you get at Dollar Tree, that's what I use to hold, hold down the button. And it actually holds it down just fine. Let's see here. I don't think I have the one I want here. I don't. Let me grab the one I'm looking for. Sorry about that. Let me see if I got one in this blue. Looks like I need to get some more buttons. There we go. Grab that one. Okay. All right, and so then you'll just take a little dot. Stick it on the back. All right. And just push that down in the center. Now, you can leave it like this if you want, you know, and trim it up a little bit. And you just leave a little button in the middle if you'd like. But I like to add a little center to it. I've got some little remnant pieces here of these little jewel embellishments, and I'm just going to stick that in the center like that. I mean, these usually come with a glue backing, but you know, if you want to make it more secure, you can always add a little glue to the back. And so if at this point, if you just want to use this as is and not stick it on anything, then there's no reason to stiffen it. You can, unless you want to glitter it, of course, you can put a little Mod Podge on it and glitter it a little bit if you'd like, so it'd stick to the fibers. But if you're wanting to stick it to a pin or some kind of little wooden stick or a popsicle or something like that, then all you got to do is grab you a little makeup sponge, which is what I have here. And sorry about that. Put a little dollop on the end of your makeup sponge, and you're just going to lightly go around these edges like this. Doesn't take a whole lot. A little bit more. This is where you can use a plastic fork if you don't want Mod Podge on your fork. I'm losing my train of thought for some reason. Great. And while this is still a little bit wet, I'm going to grab my paper here. I'm just going to slightly sprinkle this. Earlier when I was working on these, I just was tapping the side of the container and the glue came, or the glitter came flying out. And so I thought it would just be easier to sprinkle it like you're, you know, tap off the excess here. And so that's what you're kind of left with. It's got a little sparkly shimmer there. And if you want to get the glitter, you know, spread out a little bit more, this is where you would take a fork, preferably plastic, and just kind of run it through the fibers, making sure that they're not, you know, stuck laying on top of each other. And then you just let this air dry. So if you put glitter on the front, you know, I wouldn't use a hairdryer. Obviously, it'll make it, you know, go flying everywhere. And then once it's good and dry, I'm going to go ahead and do it now. But once it's, you know, probably dry, you can trim up these edges here to make it more round. Give it a haircut. So there we go. I don't quite have my fibers even on either side, but I think it's fine. So there you go. And you can glitter this up as much as you'd like. As you can see, this one doesn't have nearly as much glitter as this one. This is the one where I was tapping the jar and it just came flying out on top of the embellishment. So it's a little bit more glittery. So there you have it, some little flowers. There's this one, and then this one, and this pink one. And then this green one here that I made. It doesn't have anything on it. So, yeah. Hope you enjoyed today's project and it gave you some ideas on some ways that you can make some embellishments by using some cotton embroidery thread. Thank you so much for watching today, everyone, and y'all have a great day.